Alright, I'm trying to see if I can get this up on my phone. Hi guys. Trying to get this up on my phone here. Mother Robin's on stream as well.
Hello.
Hello guys, go back here. Hi, hello guys. And Mother Robin's on the phone as well, so you guys know. My mic's over that way, so I'm a little bit further away from the mic than normal. But basically, what I'm working on is a project for school. So basically, what I have to do is create a 3D model of a world. So render in a 3D model. So, one of the things that I'm thinking of doing, which is this project here, which is Kid and Nova's grand staircase in their house in hell. So, that's what I'm working on. My mother just got home. Hello, mother.
Nothing?
Nope.
On the phone with?
Robin's on the phone and I'm streaming. Also, not this time, guys.
I lost my mittens.
Oof.
I lost my kitty mitten.
Oof.
I don't know where.
Not this time, guys. I have Starbucks. No Tim's for me today. Starbucks it is. Because I'm rich like that. Why stream at 5? I was in the mood to stream Exotl, and I was like, I probably should stream. It would be interesting just to chill, talk, and, you know, work on this. Well, so you guys can see kind of what I'm doing for school. Do you guys want to see do you want to see the whole picture? So far?
Maybe you haven't responded?
When it's not responding, you're like, mate, no.
Yeah.
It'll have to, like, shove on the
circle. When you, like, back up the save.
Are you sure it's on that wall?
Back up the save. Well, currently it's not responding, so I gotta wait until it responds. I don't know what it is, but this program crashed on me twice today, and I have no idea why. I might actually have to close out the program. Give me a sec. I have to reopen the program. Hold on. Adobe crashed on me. gotta reopen my Illustrator because it crashed again. I don't know why it's crashing per se today. It doesn't make much sense to me.
Yeah, too many files open, that's what.
Maybe, or it's because my computer's running out of space. I don't know.
Probably a comedy shuffle.
Maybe. Oh, you guys want the Doritos? I made sure to buy Doritos. Let me just clean up the coloring here.
I did, so. Oh, well, who's leaving?
All right. We good. It's saving. We're good. Okay. All right. So there's the full picture of Kit done. And then that's so far everything for it. I have been working very hard on this. JSAB Kira, I don't know what that means. But yeah, that's it so far. It's coming along really well. And I'm very proud of how it's coming along. I'm working very hard and very diligently on it. I actually don't know what just spades and beats are. Mother Robin went home and stuff at the wrong time because I'm like, I'm working on this and I wanted her to see it, and now she's at home with no Wi-Fi and I'm like, I was listening to music, and the whole reason why I kind of got the inspiration for Kit to look like he's walking down the stairs is I'm like, it would be really good for the opening of Heroes, Legends Never Die. And I'm like, it would be a badass moment for him to be walking across the top of the railing of the main upstairs floor and then walking down the stairs for the opening. What's going on in the chat? And this is why I need Mother Robin to monitor the chat, because I don't have any mods watching the chat.
That he thought that there was, you know, if I didn't say one way or another whether I have asthma or did. So, anyway, I'll be seeing the respirologist on the 31st, so...
It's very interesting to see this all put together. The end result's going to be interesting, and I'm super excited to get the go-ahead on making this in a 3D render.
That's it. That's all it was. It was just a pop. It was actually a consult, so that's why I wasn't sure. You know. Right. So, okay.
It's very well done.
That's great, right?
Legends never die.
I'm hoping it will hold one more day.
They become a part of you. Part of you. Every time you reach on reaching greatness, relentless you survive. You never lose hope when everything cold and the fighting's near. Cause deep in their bones, when it falls off and it falls off, legends never die. They become a part of you. Every time you reach for reaching greatness, relentless you survive.
I'll make a pound of hamburger. Tomorrow night.
Singing my own music.
I hope so, because you still have to go Thursday. So please, I thought tomorrow I'll just make you. If you're gonna be late, I'll just make you
more Gravity Falls in the background.
Just the sauce in one of the containers, and then you just heat it up and put it on your buns because you want your buns toasted and stuff.
Okay.
For supper, so. It's a good night for us to have that, because she'll eat at school, because she doesn't come to 9, right? So if you come home, right, so if you pick her up, before, if you come home and eat beforehand, or you go the other way, I don't care, but I'll make that up.
My mom's on the phone and, with dad. I don't know any AJR songs.
That'll work, right?
Y'all into some stuff that I am uncultured with? Unfortunately.
I don't know. Maybe in half an hour. 6:10. Hold on for a minute. Can you just grab my bra on the one side? Just one side.
Hey, little honey.
Yeah. So yeah, I guess I'll cook it in a few minutes. I'm gonna probably throw an egg on. No, it's not. I'm gonna put an egg on now because I want an egg in the salad. So I'm gonna just boil it and get it ready and set it aside because it'll need to cool before I can unravel it.
Can you guys tell me a little bit more about AG?
All right, so AR? You're okay with salad? Okay,
like,
with salad,
I don't know enough about
bands and stuff. The,
I'm an uncultured swine, and I listen to anime songs more than I do most other songs. I'm super excited to see this finished. Oh my god. And yes, again, guys, this is with a mouse, not a tablet. I'm actually finally learning how to use a goddamn tablet. And I'm like, see? See? Now you can understand. But it's a Mac tablet and I don't have that kind of money. It's like, by the time I get the iPad Pro and stuff, it is just... And then all the software for it, I'm like, hey, I'd rather take the class for free and then worry about a tablet later. But I get to use tablet for drawing. I just see Bill blowing up in my chat room. Is we good? Spirit, if that's the case and you got an iPad Pro for Christmas, see if you can ask your parents to download Photoshop Fresco. And using the Apple Pen, try it out, start drawing. That's the program we're using currently for my class. All right, Exato, see you later. I'll be here. By the time this stream catches up, I will be finished the tale. Like that. Yeah, I'm taking a lot of precious care and time in this one than I normally do. I think that's because it's going to be turned into a 3D rendering. So it kind of has to have precise stuff to it. I'm very interested in seeing what my teacher says about it tomorrow. I'm like, this is what I want to do for my 3D... model, and I will be so depressed if I did all this work for nothing. So depressed because of how much time I've put into it.
handgun?
The nice thing is I have Kit's palette already set up. So it's very easy to maneuver with him. Speaking of Cuphead, the other day when I was with Robin at my school, I looked up at the computer animation and I literally saw Cuphead on the computer animation screen. And I'm like, yo, something I'm familiar with. Hello to everybody who's just joining. We are chilling and just watching me work on homework, I guess. That's basically what we're doing.
I'm not walking all the way down to the library.
Walk down to the library. Come look at what I'm making.
You can go back to your house and log out.
Okay, I've seen a little bit of Owl House. I haven't watched the whole thing. Is it actually legitimately like Gravity Falls? I need to know because some people on that show worked on Gravity Falls, and I gotta know if it's anything like Gravity Falls. It is. Hilda's the same way. Thank you guys for liking my videos. It makes me feel very happy. Also, I don't know how many of you know Sword Art Online, but an epiphany struck me today, and I'm like, oh my god, I can do an AMV or an MMD, which means I can do a 3D program variation of Kirito Womanizer and have all of the SAO girls dancing with him if I do the MMD and stuff, and he's just in the middle. Because I shit you not, that would be the best thing I've ever made, I think, when it comes to MMDs. Why? Because it's Kirito and it's a legit true statement. Because look at his harem. Look how big it is. You can't deny me of this. I get.
No, you can do it.
I'm gonna be putting in the lighting effects too. Look at it! It's almost done! Oh my god. It's almost done. Yes, hail to the bill dip. Here's the funny thing about my style, guys. My style is between anime and realistic, or as realistic as I can get it. Why? Because, and this is gonna piss a couple people off. So in Sheridan College, a school I go to, it's a prestigious and well-known high-tier school known for its animation courses. So, here's the deal on that. In animation, they have, and in VCA in general, so my program, the rule is no anime. You're not allowed to submit anything related to anime or have a stylistic choice like anime. Which is weird, because anime is technically an art style. It's literally something that happens and people just know it. But because how they kind of explain it is basically, oh, it's not a good art form. Why? Because it's not realistic.
6:75. I think that's the time limit. I think you only have like 70 seconds left.
So guys, at the moment, I'm not taking any requests to do drawings, as this is just strictly for my, program. So, unfortunately, I can't take requests at this time to do any drawing for anybody, as it is necessary for me to get this done in a timely fashion, because it's due tomorrow, and I just started working on it today. So, but I would totally take drawing requests had this been a normal stream, but this is more just for school and why I'm doing it. Yes, guys, welcome to college. This is my homework. I get to sit on the computer and draw. Also, guys, so you know, can I do it on, when I finish this, Sure. But only when I finish. Because I'm on track and I want to finish. But as I was going to say, guys, as you know, tomorrow's Wednesday, and Wednesday I sit between classes for 6 hours. So, as you guys saw last week, on the page, on Wednesdays, those are the days I work on Golden Surprise. So tomorrow I'm going to be working on page, I want to say, 50? Yeah, page 50. So page 50 will be out tomorrow. And stuff like that. So, with that in mind, so you guys know. And stuff like that. Because those are my days that I will work on them.
Yeah, I know how to play. Yeah, anyway. Not knowing my setup very well.
Basically, just find my
own
computer.
That's all I'm
gonna
do, and
I'm
gonna bother you
just
switching ammos or getting
mic
back.
Yeah. I just reload. Hold on. I'm gonna quiet the phone down for Robin's side. It's almost done for Kit, at least, and then I've got my other stuff. But Kit's almost done, and then I've got the rest of the background and stuff to do. Sorry for the background noise. My mom's doing the dishes.
The mini cat gave out. Not good.
Kit's almost done.
Sierra, or no?
What are they?
Chicken fingers.
Sure.
How many do you want?
Just a couple.
Just three?
No, a little bit more than three.
Huh?
A little bit more than three.
Tell her an exact number.
Four?
Can I have, like, 10?
No, I don't have 10.
Okay, then can I have, like, 7?
I can give you what I can, depending on what Dad takes and what I take for salad. That's all I have. Okay?
I want that little red eye.
Brittany ate some as well, so there's not a lot left. And how long do they 24 minutes?
I love the difference that so you guys are seeing something much different. So I believe you're looking at what is it? RGB coloring. Well, I'm looking at CMYK. So that's the little bit of color difference for you guys. So I'm using much lighter colors than actually is on my screen. I'm gonna do a small. Oh my god, it's so good. Jesus. When this is done, I'm a freak out. You all know that, right? Cause holy crap, this looks so amazing. I think this is one of the nicest ones I've done of Kit, guys, just to let you know. I've really tried to get him looking as realistic as possible. Do I like cats? Yes.
Yes, I'm a kitty. I'm a kitty.
And as you say that, I hear, is that Grim or Monkey in the background, or Becky? That meowed.
It was me.
No, there was a meow after you.
There's no cat in here. It might be Sam's game with a gun shooting.
Oh.
We can't believe we keep defeating that boss area. We can't believe it just goes straight like that. Can you reload everything there?
And their kit's done. Oh my god, it looks amazing! Yo! Welcome.
Can you talk about Firefox? I'm on for 4 hours.
I'm waiting for reactions. If you just look me, see me staring at the screen.
It's all done. Take this.
What next? What do you guys want me to do next? The staircase or the windows and the frames and stuff? What do you want me to do? Windows. I'm gonna do the frame first. Cause I've got the brown. I have to read through, so I'll have to change. Oh, no, I don't. I have it. What am I saying? I know where to get the information. Without having to close out the stream. I'm really excited to see what this would look like in a 3D rendering. I really want to be able to get this done in the proper way.
Oh, I gotta move again.
For you guys who've probably been wondering where the hell have I been for the last couple, last week, I've been kind of like struggling and vegging, trying to get back into the whole, oh, you have to be at school again thing, so homework, and I'm like, I don't want to do homework, but I gotta do homework.
Level 11 to level 17. So you can't level up mid-game? No. Well, from level 11 to level 20-something, you did pretty good.
Hey, there's the picture frame. Me hears the name Kit Nikki like and Master in the same sentence. Kit still cringes. Mm-hmm. And we have roleplay in the chat again. other window. I'm super excited to see this when it's done.
This is the only time we get up in between. Hi, should my nails be all black or all gray? It's like a lighter gray or black.
That's up to you, my love.
Hey, which one? Gray, it's not professional. Even though it's black speckled. I said it's more. Should I take a bath today? Can I take a bath? I feel like putting in one of the cupcakes. But I want a video to take it. Yeah. Take as many bites as you want. It'll be a little stale. Like the middle part's good, it's just the outer part that's a little hard. Can you try a video tape this and then post it on my channel? Was it that falling? Fizzing? Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, hi, FaZe. Welcome to the party.
But if I'm dying my hair... Oh, fuck it, I'll do it in. I'll find it, I'll just do it in there. I don't remember. Carissa. You have that Carissa in that house, so do I, but I've had this dream.
I heard, and I'm just ignoring it. I haven't really decided on the window color. Okay, we're gonna go jump into here, documents. Kids Memoir Chapter 1. Alright.
Friday, I get paid. Friday, I'm going to get the blue rose sword because my day was closed. And on that same day, I'm kicking that happy pillow. I don't care if you use the card. Yes. 4:45 p.m. to 9:15, so I'm closing tomorrow and Thursday.
and that'll be the rest of my cash I have left. Yeah. The 20 I have right now is for the commission for Sierra. So Sierra's my.
Can I meow?
Like, that's what I forgot. And I forgot Kirito.
You forgot Kirito at my house?
I forgot the poster.
Oh. You're over on Friday. I'll pick
it
up.
Where's my baby? Okay. Yeah, I'll make sure.
He's sleepy.
Yeah, let's go have a baby there.
I hear Lisa's music singing in the background, and I'm like, yes. GGO!
That's how I can instantly get your attention just for start playing SAO.
Immediate response. GGO, where? I'm so excited for this to be printed. You're gonna see it tomorrow and you're gonna be literally look at me like, how? How long did this take you? And I'm gonna be like, over 6 hours. Yes, that's how much that this is gonna take me for the duration of this. Because I started this morning in class. Well, we were watching the Brothers Grimm, and I was like, I'll pay attention, but work on project.
I'm surprised
I'm not chewing on gum right now. In a minute, guys, do you want to see my new character? Their name is Paradox. They're Echo's daughter. But there's something special about her. Let me finish this drapery and then I will show you Paradox.
My hair is already being dyed again, yes.
And actually, there's something special about Paradox. Paradox is male, trans, female. So for those of you who are that, this is something special. I don't have any trans characters, but I was just informed about Paradox, and I had thought to myself, I'm like, I want to create a trans character for a game that I have to make, in class. So I'm like, okay. I sent a message to Maggie this morning, and Maggie's like, yeah, do well, yesterday, Maggie's like, do Echo's daughter, Paradox. So I will bring her out now. Open recent files. Time travel. She's not done yet, but this is her. This is her concept art. She's adorable and I love her. I think she's very cute. I'm gonna go and do this. The daunting task in which I have taken to commit to this design. I'm hopeful that my teacher will give me the go-ahead for this. There, he's like, reference other people's designs, and I'm like, but sir, I have my own designs. I don't need to copy anybody else's designs. This is my own character. And the person sitting beside me is like, what are you gonna do? And I'm like, I'm gonna make hell. And he's like, oh my god, that's so fucking cool. And I'm like, yeah. And so I'm making the 13th realm of hell for Nova and Kit's interior for their stuff. And trust me, these types of things are no easy feats. Thanks, guys. I really appreciate your time and patience with how long this is taking. For those people who gotta go, we'll see you later.
Mystery at like level 20. Sansa will play it more than me.
Alright, there's the windows done. And hold on, and I'll put Kit in. And there you have it so far, guys. Last thing to do is the walls, the carpet, the staircase and banners, and the floor beneath. And then just add lighting effects after. But yeah, guys, it looks fantastic. I mean, for everything, you've guys seen what I've done before and stuff. This does not compare to what I've done prior. I wanna... I'm very excited for tomorrow in TechnoCraft. I'll, once my teacher looks at it, I'll, post an update on it in the community tab. Really? You guys can't see community tabs? Me and one of my fellow students started going off about the friggin', friggin' stuff for COPA. I'm like, there's so many other ways that this could have gone down. YouTube just had to be an ass and pick the worst one. Oh, by the way, hold on, now that I think about it. So you guys can see, let me save this. File, open. By the way, guys, I got you, your queen of sass right here. Yeah, I did a Lyra redraw. So, there's, if you guys ever wanted to know, there's her sheet of reference that was posted. So her deer form and stuff like that with her human form next to it. So, that's her, her concept sheet there, and then you've got Lyra, my redraw of Lyra there. to practice. I needed some of my saucy girl. How dare you, Bill?
Kitty, can help me. Kitty, I'm down. Oh wait, is that thing gonna get there? Oh shit, let me do this again.
I needed some Queen of Sass to. I started that last week on Tuesday, and then I finished it today. Because I've been busy. What I do in class, ladies and gentlemen, what I do in class. Because in my school, it's okay to doodle while you're in a lecture. So long as you're paying attention. I have one teacher who doesn't let us do that. We're not allowed to be using the computers while he's talking and stuff.
Is that good Madrins? I can't remember.
Not that I know of. But we're not allowed to. It's a computer-based class, and we're not allowed to draw and sketch and shit. In his class, and I'm like, mate, priorities much? I can't wait for you to see this when it's done. I don't know if y'all know, walking into the fandom, be like, do you guys know who I'm talking about there, who does all this fandom stuff, and what it's like in the fandom, depending on how toxic it is, and I just die. I'm like, I need her to do a Gravity Falls fandom, please. Walking into the Gravity Falls fandom, be like, Mapes, Ipica is the best. No, Bill Dip's the best. No, Dipsifica's the best. No, it's Wendip. And I'm just sitting here like, welcome to the Gravity Falls fandom, ladies and gentlemen. I need to see the reactions to this. I see. Why die Mabesifica? I need to know, understand why. I think it's a cute ship. I just, Bill, you gotta give me more here. I need you to explain to me why Mabesifica needs to die. Also, Sarah, do you want me to do the Nico 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 knee? Because I'll do it in both male and female voice if you wish.
Okay,
Alright. I'll do female feet first. Nico, 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 ni. And then, Nico, 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 ni. There you go, guys. Kit, there's Kit's Nico, 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 ni for you. He's done it to Robin a couple of times. It's especially funny when he's got the cat ears on and his tail. And Robin just dies every time she hears it. Voice cracks. Do I deal with voice cracks? Sometimes. Not all the time. At this point, Kit's pretty good using my vocal cords. So I don't usually worry. You learn to get used to a male alternate personality at this point. Is that the little child?
Yes, it's the little child.
Little child, bed.
It's not even her bedtime, it's not even 8. What do you want, child? I can't pause it. No. Mine. No. Oh, no. Kita, I love you.
I have a good Aussie voice. Good day, mate. There you go.
Is that okay?
Yup.
Spares about 8.
Hello, father. Welcome. My father's gonna put on the TV. I'm on a Okay, we're gonna have to deal with leaf noise, background noise, because GG, the game's on, and the game needs to be on. But yes, stream will kind of be weird considering that there's going to be heavy duty background noise due to the TV. So forgive me, guys.
In 14 games since Rick Bonus took over, they now sit second in the Central.
Let me know if it's too loud and I'll try and adjust the mic setting. Probably adjust the mic setting. Is that better, guys? Can you hear? I can't tell of my audio. I just hope it's better. When there's a massive leg spike and you're like, no! There, that's a voice crack, guys, for me. I don't get them often. I see Chinese or Kanji in my chat. Bill, is that Chinese or Kanji?
Never imagined. Say hello to my Popeye's ghost pepper wings. 6 wings and a biscuit for just $6.99.
If I was not using my phone that could decipher what that says, I'd friggin' check. What happened? Who dared who? What? Oh, now Bill's just typing in kanji. Okay.
Repairs and rentals. The only shop that can handle all your auto clean needs in one place.
feels like. TD Insurance, ready for you.
When we at Miller Lite set out to brew a light beer, there came a moment of truth. When we had to choose. Great taste.
Bill, arigato gozaimasu.
It's Miller time.
Well, it's been a tough start so far for Louis Domingue, but to say he was fired up before this game would be an understatement. Basically sprinting on the ice, the enthusiasm probably comes from the fact that he's coming off a win over the Tampa Bay Lightning, his former team, and in a great article at The Athletic, he talked a little bit about that experience, specifically what Julien Brisebois told him.
Well, if you really think about it, and hear me out here, Bill is an all-powerful being that's been around for God knows how long. You'd think Bill would know several different languages, right? From his travels around the world. So you have to weigh these options, right?
They really try offensively, as we showed you earlier in the period, the lock was taken.
There's Tyson Perry. Breaks out of his own hand.
All right, Bill.
Pop back for Marner. He'll get it through center. Play back for Nylander. It's good. Caught for an offside.
It was a bit of a flipper that slowed down Nylander enough for everybody offside as Marner was on his backhand. He didn't get a lot on the pass. And it really wasn't Nylander's fault. He had to stop and wait for the puck, and the result of that.
Perry for Matthews. Back to Perry.
You've got a headcanon if Dipper's out on like business or something and Bill goes with him. It's like, you are my universal translator now. You don't get this option. And Bill just looks at him like, wait, what?
Do you have enough dressing to get through?
Huh?
You have enough dressing?
I do. I hope you do.
I got a bit. Yeah, I forgot. That was something I forgot to get.
Ice.
I went to get it and they didn't have it in one place.
Huh?
And I forgot. I just crossed off my wrist like a
snake.
The second power play unit, you're going to see Sandin on the ice. He's got a real good one-timer as well. Rasmus Sandin drops it back for Jason Spezza. Up through center, and he'll hand it off for Kapanen. Down into the corner, Spezza picks it up. From center, block, break, chance for Johnson, and he's stopped by Domingue.
Betts is going tonight, isn't he? Gets a big assist. Very similar to how he did this. Goes to the puck. And sets up Andreas Janssen, who gets it away in a hurry, and a good read by Domingue as he makes a good positional save.
I wish I knew more Japanese.
He's got the face off against Blake Coleman here with 24 seconds to go on the Leafs power play. Hucks is free at the top. Janssen can put a poke at it. Hyman after it. Chandler up with Suhanen. Hyman around the goal, off the board to the point where Kapanen plays it for Sandin. Backhand pass for Spezza. Spezza back for Rasmus Sandin. Feeds it over. Kapanen fires and it's blocked by Domingue. As Suhanen will smack it down the ice.
I can't emphasize enough how impressed I am with this Sandin. I was to begin with, and I think he's just a terrific player. He can play.
Peterson around, back to the net. Pritchard gets it up the board. Kusev is here. He'll lift it out at center. Kapanen waiting for it to bounce in front of him. Rides on the puck. That will snap it towards the net. It's high over the goal. Butcher. A drop pass for Kusev. Peterson. Into the corner for Butcher. He's taken up by Marichin. Or Peterson trying to get to it. Check that. And now here comes Engvall with Butcher back. Engvall. Oh, it shoots. And he just got a short drive.
The hockey game's going on.
Nico Hischier.
All right, Sebastian, see you later. Say hi to CL for us. Also tell Mayrin not to go sniper mode.
And out of play. Frederick Gauthier with a goal to make it 2-0 Toronto with it.
during the goal in the moment with his coach. All smiles. Folsom Canadian Leafs hockey on Sportsnet.
Leafs are winning 2-0 against the Devils. When a Timmy's commercial comes on and you'd be
imagine
like...
a world where everyone puts safety first. Where no one thinks twice about sharing the road. And a safe journey is as important as the destination.
Oh, I have a friend. Come on.
We make it easy to live safely and reward you along the way.
Come on.
Come on,
baby.
We can make a safe
come on, baby. Come on, Kelly. Come on. All right, there we go. There's your cat friend.
A truck that can set the pace. Handle everything you throw at it. Handle everything that is thrown at you. Take care of your demands. Take care of your squad. Thinking on your feet is an active truck. Forging your own path is an active truck. The Toyota Tundra. The Toyota Tacoma. Made for acts of truck.
It's not 8 o'clock yet.
A couple of days ago, and the interim general manager now is the man who was the assistant manager, Tom Fitzgerald. And here's a look at him, of course, a former Leaf. A real solid person. He'll do a great job. It'll be interesting to see if he gets the job at the end of the season. And don't forget, we've got Martin Brodeur, who I saw before the game saying, well, I guess I'm back in the fire, as he was trying to maybe get away from it a little bit in an advisory role. Back in the fire, perhaps a candidate as well to be a manager here for the New Jersey Devils. Both good people, both very good, solid hockey people, and the pay their dues to manage the
team. Puck picked up back in the net by Simmons, trying to get it in front. Wood knocked it down, and Miles Wood will turn and dump it back in the lead zone as Anderson's had a net to stop it. Plays it for Justin Hall, up on the wing off the stick of Pierre Engvall. Andy Green, back on it for New Jersey. Tavares, trying to get it away from Wayne Simmons. Dermott back on the puck. Devils on the line change. Dermott will wait.
My turn, Emily left down.
The sand here is Dermott now. Hands it off into the skates of Marner. He'll work it into the New Jersey zone. Back on it, trying to catch that door. That in his front. Got it up for Bolkus, tipped down the ice. It's going to be an icing call against New Jersey.
This period brought to you by the Toyota RAV4. There's more out there.
Sportsnet ice surfing, streaming live on Twitter every Tuesday from 7 to 10.
Did you have to lift the garage this morning yet? Did you have to lift the garage?
Hmm?
Or did it open?
I had to lift it, yes.
Did it just put a little bit of force on it? That's all you have to do, is just a little bit.
Yeah.
Just getting it over that first hump.
I just can't do it with my right arm. I have to do it with my left.
Well, to be honest, I don't think you'd even notice the difference.
Yeah, I did notice. I tried with the right and I couldn't even get it to move. I didn't have enough strength.
I should show you how to do it. Seems to require a lot of strength.
But then it's fine with the other one. I don't know.
Oh. This is for
and Hyman, near his normal spot, draws the attention. You're right, John. After he with a couple of extra shoves as that puck was going through. And
he's trying to play some.
Now the puck's going to happen. And Demink, we talked about him a little bit. Being pretty upset, as Sean told us, after getting let go by the Tampa Bay Lightning. And here's his tweet. Where he got the chance to get a couple of starts, and he not only did just that, but ended up beating the Tampa Bay Lightning and the Washington Capitals over the weekend.
Yeah,
the Tampa Bay one was pretty sweet for him. .959 save percentage in his last three appearances and two starts for the Devils. One is only career game against Toronto. Trying to make that two tonight. Here's Cody Ceci.
If I do this,
got the outside of the net. Johnson back to the goal, trying to hook it back for Ceci.
Oh my god, this guy looks incredible.
Butcher chops at it at center. Kerfoot follows up the play, got the pass from Ceci. They'll lift it in and Demings had a net to stop it. Feeds it back in the corner for Butcher. Left the boards for
Brock. What a hot topic main headquarters is, that's why.
Nico Heischer hands it up for Connor Carroll. He'll gain the line. Carroll with his shot and missed.
This is not like my guy.
Now it's Hall. Up for Kerfoot. Back into the corner. Hall going after a penalty coming up here. Subban and Timoshoff were all tangled up, but Subban's going to get called for interference, and the Leafs will get a power play. Subban wins his case.
Well, maybe that makes it a little even from the one you might have got earlier in the period. And by the blue line to the right of your screen, I mean, that's just straight interference. It's a penalty. I don't know what he's upset about, to be quite honest with you.
So the Leafs power play goes to work for the second time tonight. And they win the draw as Tyson Perry will set it up. Plays it across for Matthews, got it back. Here's Marner with it. In front, Matthews with a chance and got it a little too tight. Marner knocks it down along the boards. Tavares. Playing it down for Nylander. Nylander handing it off for Marner. Trying to go back for Tavares. Had a reach for it. Got it to the point. Tyson Berry walks in with a shot. Tipped in its wide. Nylander after it. Batted up the boards. Berry holds in. Great play at the line. Marner trying to go back for Matthews. Cut off by Coleman. And Blake Coleman will skip it to center. And now deflected into the corner. Coleman trying to hold off Berry. And then he takes a hit from Tavares. Marner goes down, but he got the puck for Tavares. Up to center, across for Nylander. Off his stick, and Green trying to clear it.
Barry got hurt a bit here. I'm not sure what's wrong with him. Keep an eye on him.
Sandin plays it off for Marner. Back for Sandin. Austin Matthews to Rasmus. Sandin with a shot. Makes it through. And Demink makes the stop.
I mean, the boy, there's a Barry on the bench. I'm not quite sure what happened. He seems to be okay, but he was favoring his neck a bit. And I think it was Traverse's hit. Yeah, it is. Watch what happens here. Yeah, he twists his neck a little bit when Coleman goes in to Berry after Traverse with the hit. And I'm sure Berry wasn't expecting that, so he really didn't brace himself the way he probably normally would have.
Green gets it around the top of the glass, and then it ends up out of play.
And I think he's going to be okay now. There's only a little... here. And here's the play. I mean, it was just a heartless play. He's going back for the puck battle. Here comes Tavares. And he didn't see it coming, and he wasn't quite ready for it. But he seems to be okay after that play.
Chiefs don't want to lose another of their defensemen. Here's Rasmus Sandin. Along the line. Looks towards the net. Hands it out for Spezza. Jason Spezza with a shot. Goes off the skate. Now gets it right back. Spezza to the point for Sandin. Holds his own as he'll feed it over to Kapanen. Right back in front. Spezza going to the net. And in the slot. Kerfoot's got the Janssen's knocked down. Here's Sandin scores! Set time in. I believe. Tipped it in front. Hyman being knocked down. Got his stick on it. And tips it over. Power play goal. And it's 3-0 Toronto.
Yeah, you know, Hyman gets credit with Sandin again. I mean, what a power play quarterback he is on this shift. I mean, this time he moves it so beautifully. He's got to the point. He's going to get it here. Walks the line, finds it, and drops it. And there's Hyman on the way down. Keeps his eye on the puck. Sandin shooting from the tip.
What a tip that is.
Unbelievable. As Vantanen is all over. This kid's got 2 points already. Ho-hunk. Welcome back to the National Hockey League. They may have a look at this for a couple. A high stick. Oh, seems to be fine.
So after being down 3-0 in the first period of Florida, the Leafs come back home. They outshoot the Devils 16-7 and have a 3-0 lead over the New Jersey Devils. David Amber, Todd Werner, Colby Armstrong coming up in our intermission. Tavares, Gauthier, and Hyman with the goals as Toronto's hit 3-0. 20 on the season.
Engine with 395 horses, but when you give it a hybrid system, make it more efficient than ever before, attach it to an 8-speed torque flight transmission, and watch it tow almost 6 tons without breaking a sweat. That's the power to innovate. Ram 1500, Canada's most awarded light duty truck of 2019. Get up to $10,500 in discounts, plus lease rates as low as 2.99%.
By the fact that this is on
what's the matter, Diego?
Don't be fetchy.
Well, this guy likes chicken wings.
You can talk to animals.
What?
Hello, buddy.
Is that it?
Special.
How did you do this?
I just watched a little video.
You're so nice, right?
Flambe. Flambe.
The new Beyond Meatball Marinara Sun is now available only at Subway. How do you grow these plant-based meatballs? Gently plant one in a bed of marinara. And 8 weeks later, you have this. I tended them with sterling silver shears, but truly, any silver will do. They must be kept at approximately 62.7 degrees Celsius. Any higher, and I fan them by hand. I made this one ahead of time, but you can get yours at Subway.
Holy crap.
We all sweat. We sweat for work. We sweat for play. That's why we built our most innovative and strongest trucks ever. Because either way, here in Canada, we prefer to sweat for something worth sweating for. Introducing our strongest, most capable Silverados ever. Because there's work to be done.
The NHL's biggest names and brightest stars converge
on Sportsnet.
A weekend full of skills.
Sportsnet.
Where slackers bring the heat and wristers hit the mark.
This guy's lightning quick.
Then with 3-on-3, anything can happen.
On Sportsnet.
Snipers you can't miss. Goalies who flash left. And must-see moments that'll make you go. The 2020 Honda NHL All-Star Weekend. Sportsnet.
Welcome into the Sportsnet Studios. Most in Canadian Leafs hockey. Great to have you along. Colby Armstrong, Todd Werner, David Amber. They wanted a bounce back. They needed a bounce back. And so far, so good. 3-0 Leafs after 20 minutes. And what can you say about this new look blue line? So far, so good. Especially Rasmus Sandin.
Well, Sandin now, you look at his career in the NHL. 4 assists. And now just his 7th game. And, you know, we talked at the pregame show about opportunity, guys getting opportunity with Muzzin and now Riley out of the lineup. And we look here at the penalty kill. Marincin, Dermott, we've seen time here on the PK. SCC's the top PK time per game on the Leafs. So guys are getting opportunities in these situations. I think they did a good job on the
one kill they had. The last thing to do is the stairs. And then just after that is literally just lighting.
So you know what? Somebody else is going to find somebody else and grab them and bring them into the battle. So.
Freedom.
and breaking new ground. The QX50. For whatever your destination.
At 15, Jose de Jesus Rodriguez, 6 under, 2 back, but maybe wondering what could have been. Just got a few more holes to go on a picture perfect Tuesday. Winds are up here at Samuels at Old Bay.
At Farmers Insurance, we've seen almost everything, so we know how to cover almost anything, even a gold medal grizzly.
What an unlikely field in this final heat. Hang on. You're about to see history in the making.
Not exactly a skinny dipper, but we covered it. At Farmers, we know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two.
We are Farmers.
Visit farmers.com and get a quote today.
Well, my current putter, I think I'm lined up right, and you know the ball just continues to miss it up.
Very
good.
I do not let all that often.
I struggle with alignment.
Oh, thank you.
I seem to miss the ball left or right, but just by fractions. Fractions in putting will result in missed putts.
Missing makeable putts can completely destroy your confidence and your score. But with the brand new S7K standalone putter, you'll have the confidence to crush your line every single time and easily sink your putt.
The S7K is such an accurate putter because it gets you on the line from the get-go.
The S7K, I'm confident it can shave 2 or 3 strokes around for me.
It couldn't have been easier than light up my putts.
Where do you look? My ball is that baby.
Step behind. You don't have to worry about all the variables. Warm up. Make a great stroke. It's in the hole.
Mm-hmm. Go to S7KPutter.com now to see how golfers like you are lowering your score with the consistency and precision of the brand new S7K standalone putter. That's S7KPutter.com.
There was a girl who lost her sight. Because she lost her sight, she couldn't read or learn like the others. She couldn't work to help support her family.
Could have added more chicken, but Sarah needed it to eat.
Then Sarah came and restored her sight.
I noticed that.
Now she can learn.
Yeah, I'm almost finished this way.
Sarah has helped her with
five more
countries.
Not enough to get through.
Why are you? That was good. This author is experimenting with a highly classified material.
Well, it tastes good with the chicken.
It's very much.
Scratch? Almost
finished. You eat all the
right? No, there's a little bit left that you come home and you eat something, then have a little salad with it. It's not very much. You might get a half a bowl out of it. Or I might take it to school before the...
Right next to school.
I will try.
Is there any more dressing?
Because I also have Friday. I'm here by myself Friday. You're going to be...
For the 4 straight years.
Probably a bed for a little bit after the...
This week. And then next week, it will be played at Royal Blue Golf Club in Nassau. That's because the first 3 years...
My hand's starting to cramp. That's how you know it's been a long time.
Hurricane Dorian. Go back to September 1st. When the most intense tropical cyclone to ever strike the Bahamas hit the Abaco Islands. 185 mile per hour sustained winds, 220 mile per hour gust. But there has been an outpouring of love and support from the Sandals Foundations and everyone in the Caribbean. What can they do? Open
my last Christmas present.
Donate some money, help them. It's going to be a long rebuilding, but hashtag Abaco Strong. We are thinking of everyone down there. We know you will be back better than ever.
Yeah, Matt DeMace, who's a superintendent there, is actually going to be helping next week. He rode that storm out. Jim Duncan, head of rules and competitions, was telling us that Matt, when he rode out, the walls were bending in his head.
I can do it right.
USAA Insurance made just the way Martin's family needs it. With hassle-free claims, he got paid before his neighbor even got started. Because doing right by our members, that's what's right. USAA. What you're made of? We're made for.
I don't know why I love you, but I do. I don't know why I cry so, but I do. I don't know why I love you, but I do.
Everything your trip needs. For everyone you love, Expedia. If you have moderate to severe psoriasis, little things can be a big deal. That's why there's Otezla, Otezla is not a cream. It's a pill that treats plaque psoriasis differently. With Otezla, 75% clear skin is achievable. Don't use if you're allergic to Otezla. It may cause severe diarrhea, nausea, or vomiting. Otezla is associated with an increased risk of depression. Tell your doctor if you have a history of depression or suicidal thoughts, or if these feelings develop. Some people taking Otezla reported weight loss. Your doctor should monitor your weight and may stop treatment. Upper respiratory tract infection and headache may occur. Tell your doctor about your medicines and if you're pregnant or planning to be. Otezla, show more of you.
Hey, I'm Zach, CEO of Roman. Some health issues are tough to talk about. With Roman, you can go online, chat with a physician, and if treatment
last
is right for you, we'll ship FDA-approved medication right to
the lighting,
let's take care of it.
Effects and stuff.
I know that I'm in love with this girl, and I hope that she's in love with me. It's a big deal. I mean, it's not easy for anybody.
The Windsors, Inside the Royal Dynasty, premieres Sunday, February 16th at 10 on CNN.
Good morning, Charlie.
It's cold outside.
I bet if I moved in, you'd become president.
Why not? Stay in.
Totality style.
CTV throwback and CTV movies.
The future lies with you.
Series and movies, all totally free.
I'll never forget it.
We can be on TV.
No subscription.
Ayo. Oh, wait.
No sign-in required.
You're constantly amazing.
Slow and nice. Nobody gets hurt. CTV throwback and CTV movies.
Mom, it's Saturday. I don't have to spell on Saturday.
Stream anytime at CTV.ca and the CTV app.
It's all so different.
Pugsby, don't drink at all. This gentleman wants some too.
What a nervous man.
These people are monsters. They'll ruin the neighborhood. Hey, man.
Totally awesome.
Next on CNN. Just over an hour, the top six Democratic candidates will be taking the stage you see there in Des Moines, Iowa. It is the final showdown before the first vote in Iowa on February 3rd. Everyone
oh
is
my
back
God,
with
guys, it looks so good.
The single most important thing I'm watching tonight is to see how much these candidates want to fight. Just 20 days out from the caucus, and how much they want to de-escalate. There are a lot of fights teed up here, Aaron. The Sanders versus Biden fight we talked about, the Warren versus Sanders. Is this going to be a brawl and a really intense debate, or are they going to try to dial that back a bit?
John? I think Amy Klobuchar really has to win this debate. I called her the winner of the last debate, but this could be it for her. She had a good debate. She raised a lot of money, comparatively for her. But I don't know how she goes out of Iowa, not in at least third place. I don't know what the road is for her after that. So I'm looking for her to...
Right, I mean, she's Midwestern senator.
This is
she,
right, this is her state.
Karen, I'm looking forward to seeing how the candidates balance attacking their opponents, which is how you win a debate, with attracting their opponents' supporters, which is how you win a caucus. And I'm looking forward to a debate that matters. In actual votes.
Right, which it's interesting, as you say. So to succeed in one area, you may have to fail in another. Nia.
Yeah, can Warren and Buttigieg get their momentum back, right? They have cooled after having pretty hot streak in some of these early states, and since then they faded a little bit. Might sort of have flatlined. So that's going to be the big question for me. How are they able to kind of get back in the mix and convince voters that they're actually electable in this crucial time?
Now it's 8 o'clock.
Thank you all very much, and thanks to all of you for joining us. We are just an hour away from the CNN Democratic presidential debate.
ABC
360 with Anderson Cooper starts now.
And good evening from Drake University in Des Moines, Iowa, site of this evening's CNN Des Moines Register Democratic presidential debate, the final debate for Iowa's caucus just 20 days from now. The clock is ticking. So the six candidates, for the six candidates on the stage tonight, the stakes are high, the urgency great, and so is the incentive to try and stand out. 45% of likely caucus goers in a new CNN Des Moines Register poll say they still could be persuaded to support someone other than their first choice. 13% say they have no first choice yet. The question is, what will each candidate do to try to change that? The crowd tonight is ramped up. Will tonight's small runs for shape the dynamic, and how will other events like the showdown with Iran inform the proceedings? We're going to get answers to those questions and more starting about 59 minutes from now when the debate starts. Right now, we're joined by former DNC chairman and Virginia Governor Terry McAuliffe, Jess McIntosh, Director of Communications Outreach for the 2016.
Being kept secret. And then should the high-profile extradition case of Meng Wanzhou be televised? A judge says no. What do you think? The press gallery weighs in on that and on the Bloc Québécois leader's swipe at Prince Harry and Meghan and who might pay for their security costs in Canada. This is Power Play. Let's get to the players. All right, as Canadian investigators get to examine the evidence of the down plane in Iran, or as much as the Iranians will let them, dramatic new video has just emerged of the missiles firing at the plane. In Iranian CCTV footage, we see the two Iranian missiles fired 30 seconds apart at flight PS752, killing all 176 passengers on board. Just dramatic to see this. There are now three key areas of concern, of course. First is the access to the evidence, something investigators are fighting for. Then there's compensation for the victims from both Iran and the airline involved. Why did that plane take off in the first place? And then consequences. Consequences for those responsible for the tragic deaths. And it's this last issue that's now provoking a political debate. In an interview with Global News, Prime Minister Justin Trudeau went from holding Iran accountable for the shooting of the plane, and he has done that, to proportioning some of the blame onto the United States. Check this out.
I think if there were no tensions, if there was no escalation recently in the region, those Canadians would be right now home with their families. This is something that happens when you have conflict and war. Innocents bear the brunt of it, and it is a reminder why all of us need to work so hard on de-escalation, on moving forward to reduce tensions and find a path that doesn't involve further conflict and killing.
The Trudeau comments contrast with new comments from the former Prime Minister, Stephen Harper, who was speaking at a conference in India. Check out what he said.
I don't think any of us believe that Iran would have deliberately shot down an aircraft, but the very fact that Iran believing such a thing could happen would be allowing normal civilian traffic, I think, tells you something about the nature of that regime and its priorities. And I do believe we need to see a change in Iran if we are going to see peace in the Middle East.
So who's right here exactly? Is Mr. Harper right to promote regime change now, or does his past record on things like regime change in places like Iraq make those comments reckless? Or is it prudent for Justin Trudeau to blame the U.S. actions as one of the causes of deaths in the midst when there are key allies? Let's call on the players to see how Canada should move forward on consequences. Arif Virani is a Liberal MP. He joins us from Toronto. Tom Kamesh is a Tory MP and the party's National Caucus Chair. He comes to us from Calgary. And Heather McPherson is the NDP MP.
All right, guys, there you go.
Thanks all of you for joining us. Very difficult time. Referring, I'll start with you.
It's finished.
Why is the Prime Minister placing some of the blame for the tragic plane downing on the tensions and escalations between the U.S. and Iran?
Well, I think it's important to look at what the Prime Minister said and what the Prime Minister has been experiencing over the last few days. What he's been doing has been reaching out to Canadians and the families that have been affected by this tragedy
this
over the last several
really
days. And
well
what he's been hearing
done.
From them is a range of emotions. He's focused on those families, and those families
Other
are expressing everything from bitter
one last
loss
thing
and
that I forgot.
To senses of outrage and anger as to what's transpired. And what he's hearing from them and what Canadians know to be a stated fact is that we've got a region that in the last 7 to 10 days has seen a significant rise in tensions. Those tensions have produced an outcome. That outcome would not have been likely had the tensions not risen. And what the Prime Minister stated is something that I think all people can appreciate as a matter of common sense, that when there are tensions in a region and there's conflict, people who are innocent are sometimes pay the ultimate price.
And I agree, and I think it's obvious to everyone there's collateral damage and the ongoing tension. But has he expressed blame to the United States for not sharing information that directly led to this tragic missile launch?
What he's done is he's reached out to other world leaders, including President Trump, but also the leaders of the other nations that are affected, who are victims from this horrible, horrible tragedy. What we're trying to do is what Canada has always done best in terms of its international engagement.
All right, guys, there you have it. It's finished. Holy shit.
Springs it in, Wood didn't clear. It's an offside. Well, the Maple Leafs continue their role. They got away from it a bit at first periods, but here tonight, Sandin with just two terrific shots walking the line for the tip. And Gauthier with the one goal as well, a nice individual effort by Jason Spezza to get the puck over. And Daisy being wrecked by Hyman also on that goal.
Here it ball. We'll get it in. Domingue down to the net, stops it. Played it around the glass, Simmons waiting for it, but Engvall swipes it back for Tavares. John Tavares, Pierre Engvall scores!
Alright guys, I've been streaming for 2 hours, and I wanted to get this done for you guys so you could see it. But I think the right thing to do here now is give myself a little break. Thank you all for watching and enjoying the artwork. And I will see you guys later.